The D Rex.
Yeah, shout out my nigga from D's Media, you feel me?
Yo, it's your boy D's Media back again with another video. Like, comment, subscribe to the channel on the road to 100K. Today we're going to talk about Meek Mill and how he went from the hometown hero man to man being a poop putt. Let's jump straight into it. Meek Mill, man, when Meek Mill came to the music scene and he came to the forefront, Philadelphia held him down. You know, we remember Meek Mill from being 15 and 16, rapping with his nappy braids, rubber band on his wrist, holding it down for Philly. You know, Philly had this man back. You know what I'm saying? They've been rocking with Meek since forever. You know, this was the hometown hero, born and raised. You know, Philadelphia, man, they groom Meek. What I mean by groom is no different from planting a flower and watching it grow. That's what Philadelphia did with Meek Mill. This was the guy that was going to take Philadelphia to the top where it never been. You got to think, other than like Benny Siegel, maybe a Freeway, nobody really had the national notoriety and like really was Philadelphia made and Philadelphia, like Philadelphia never really been too much mainstream in the industry other than Benny Siegel, you know, State Property when they had their run with Rockefeller. But just really think about and pay attention. Other than Benny Siegel and maybe Freeway, well, Young Gunners too. Young Gunners came with a hit, so I got to give them their credit. But nobody really had a good run for representing Philly. You know, a lot of people could try to bring up Will Smith. That was before my time. You know, Summertime was a big hit. He was the first rapper to ever win a Grammy. So I guess we can never overlook his accomplishments and what he did for Philadelphia and just to hip hop in itself. So we not going to skip over that. Who else did they have? Cassidy. Cassidy had his run. He had a couple hits. You know, he had his nice little run, but he was more so, I would kind of say, a battle rapper. You know, I felt like Cassidy, when he had his turn, he was the hometown hero. He was more so representing Philadelphia in a street battling way. You get what I'm saying? You know, I get my 50 dudes, you get your 50 dudes, we show up, we battle it out. You know what I'm saying? I didn't never feel like Cassidy really could make a hit. I felt like Cassidy represented Philadelphia for the battling, like, you know, the Reed Dollars, you know what I'm saying? Because we got to get at to Philadelphia. Philadelphia is pure lyricist. Not going to really see too many mumble rappers, like Lil Uzi, you know, maybe, but Philadelphia is more so hardcore lyrics. You got to really rap, you know what I'm saying? So when Meek came to the forefront, you know, and Ross signed him, you know, he took off, you know, because Philadelphia didn't have that voice in the second. Then on top of that, you put this young dude that's gritty, grimy, got the lyrics. He got the image of a street dude, and you put him next to Lavish Rick Ross, the boss, you know, Versace, Gucci, you know, Bel Air Boys. You know, you put Meek next to him, it was a match made in heaven. So Meek took off. Like I say once again, Meek Mill can really rap. He got the grimy flow, the rich lyrics, the lifestyle. Like he got everything. You know what I'm saying? And he'd been preparing for this moment his whole life. Meek Mill just didn't step into the limelight. That man took 15, 20 years to even blow up. His first deal with Tip didn't work out. He kept going, kept going, kept going. He finally got his breaking point when he got with Ross. And the city loved it because they groomed Meek. You know what I'm saying? But as you starting to see, fast forward in 2024, Meek Mill don't get that same love that he got in 2007, 2008, when Philadelphia was all about Meek. I like my rose red and my diamonds blue. I like my rose red and my diamonds blue. Look how Philadelphia turned their back on them. You get what I'm saying? Every rapper that come up, QT7 Quanti, Poundside Pop, you know, YBC Dude, all these young dudes from Philly don't respect Meek. They don't rock with Meek. And I'm wondering why, you know what I'm saying? But as I'm starting to learn that Meek Mill is self-centered and he caught up in his own ways, you know, I feel like Meek Mill feel like Philadelphia groomed him so long that it's hard for him to share the spotlight because it was always about him. The bag was on Meek. Everybody in Philly was betting on Meek. And now you got artists like Lil Uzi, to where Lil Uzi outsell Meek on a bad day. You know? Like, it's Philly ain't all about Meek no more. And I feel like it's hard for that guy to swallow that because he's been the hometown hero for so long. He don't know how to pass that torch. You know, when you running in a race, you know what I'm saying? You got to pass that torch to your homie or the person running with you. And it's now it's their turn to keep up the pace. And then you got to pass it to somebody else. And now it's their turn to keep up the pace. That's how you win the race. That's how Philadelphia would have won the race. You know, Meek Mill got on, passed the torch to Quelly. Quelly passed the torch to Pound. Pound passed the torch to QT7 Kwani. Kwani passed the torch to this. YBC Duel passed the torch to this. That's how you keep it going. And it all start with Meek Mill starting a race, getting in lead, passing the torch off, not starting the race and keeping the torch and just keep running. You know, but I honestly feel like the streets of Philadelphia turned on Meek Mill in the music and in the streets. You know, I feel like a lot of Meek Mill's selfish ways got him to this point to where Philadelphia turned their back on him. You know, you got his homie Dean coming out, you know, a real stepper from Philadelphia. You know, he calling Meek out. You know, you got all the up and coming artists calling Meek out. You know, you got old employees from Philly calling Meek out. You know, and then you got a person like Lil Uzi that just went to Philadelphia, you know, booked a studio session and got all the up-and-coming artists out of Philadelphia in one studio session. Lil Uzi did that. The one with all the piercings, the one that they say be dancing, be mumble rapping, and be all of that. It's crazy that the streets of Philadelphia respect Lil Uzi more than Meek Mill. You know? But like I say, if you don't believe me, don't take my word for it. Just go look and pay attention. All these guys is coming out and blasting me. But ain't nobody coming out and saying nothing bad about Lil Uzi. Lil Uzi is the hometown hero. Lil Uzi is the face of Philadelphia. Lil Uzi is the face of the streets of Philadelphia. Lil Uzi is Philadelphia. I'm gonna be honest with you. Philadelphia is Little Uzi's now. It's not Meek Mill's no more. But shout out to Meek Mill and the Dream Chaser. This video was not to bash anybody or anything like that. It's just a critique of, you know, all the stuff that's been coming out about Meek Mill and just how all these Philly dudes is just turning their back on them. But I remember in 2009 when they was pushing for Meek, rooting for Meek, like, all day long on Twitter, sign Meek, sign Meek, sign Meek, sign Meek, sign Meek, sign Meek. Now he don't got that same love. It's your boy D's Media signing out. Like, comment, subscribe to the channel on the road to 100K.
The D, man. Yeah, shout out my nigga from D's Media, you feel me?